Hello, kids! Welcome back to our wonderful world of learning. Today, we're going on a journey into the world of math. And we'll be learning about some really important basic symbols. Are you ready? Let's start with the most fundamental symbol.
This symbol is called the equals sign. We use this sign to show that two things are the same. For example, 5 equals 5, or 1 equals 1, or even 3 cats equals 3 cats, doesn't it? We also use the equals sign to show the result when we do a math operation. For instance, 2 plus 3 equals 5. Now, let's move to other symbols. That way, we can understand better with examples.
This is a plus sign, also known as the addition symbol. We use this symbol when we want to bring two numbers together. For instance, if we have one apple and we add three more apples, how many apples do we have in total? Yes, 1 plus 3 equals 4 apples.
This is a minus sign, or the subtraction symbol. We use this symbol when we want to take one number away from another. For instance, if we have 4 bananas and we eat one, how many bananas are left? 4 minus 1 equals 3 bananas.
This is called the multiplication symbol. We use this symbol when we want to multiply two numbers. Let's say you have three friends, and you give three tangerine slices to each of them. How many tangerine slices did you give in total? Yes, 3 multiplied by 3 equals 9 slices.
This is the division symbol. We use this symbol when we want to divide one number by another. For example, imagine I have a pizza. I have three friends, and I want to share the pizza with them and myself. So I divide the pizza into 4 slices, and each of us gets one slice.
Another example. If you have 8 strawberries and you share them with 4 friends, how many strawberries does each friend get? Yes, 8 divided by 4 equals 2 strawberries. Lastly, these two symbols are the less than and greater than signs. We use these symbols to show that one number of objects is less or greater than another number of the same type of objects. For instance, having 3 balloons is less than having 4 balloons. So, we can say that 3 is less than 4. But having 5 balloons is greater than having 4 balloons. This time, we can say that 5 is greater than 4.
Great work, kids! Let's try a bit of a complex math problem. Imagine I gave 2 balls to each of my 3 friends, and I also kept 4 balls for myself. How many balls are there in total?
Well done, kids! That concludes today's video. Today, we learned some really important math symbols, and I bet you're all going to be math whizzes in no time. Remember, practice makes progress. Try using these symbols in your daily activities as well as in your homework. Stay curious and keep learning. See you in the next video. Take care and see you next time.